हेलो एवरीवन, वी हैव स्टार्टेड सेकेंड चैप्टर इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस इन द फर्स्ट लेक्चर अबाउट द लैंड रिसोर्सेज एंड दिस इज द सेकेंड लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द सॉयल रिसोर्सेज. सो लेट्स बिगिन. व्हाट आर द सॉयल रिसोर्सेज? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, सॉयल इज एन एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट. एबायोटिक component. So what is the soil? Soil is the basically, see, this is the earth. The uppermost layer is the known as the crust. Then second layer is the known as the mantle, and third one is the core. So the uppermost layer of the crust have the thin layer of the granular substance. This is known as the soil. It is the made up of organic matters, minerals, weathered rocks found in the earth, and in formation of the 1 centimeter soil, it takes millions of the years. Okay, and what is the soil profile? Soil profile means to understand layers of the soils, compositions of the soil is known as the soil. Soil profile. The soil profile is basically have the 4 layers. First layer, the top soil with the humus and the vegetation. Means if any plant is growing and we are seeing the topmost layer, that is the first layer in which the humus means the some organic compound when the diagnosis there known as the humus. And the vegetation means plants are growing there. And second layer is the known as the subsoil. In subsoil, the salt means the sand, silt and the clay found there. In the third layer, the weathered rock material found. In the fourth layer, the parent rocks found. This total four, there are the four. Here is the parent rocks. Rocks are the basically 3 types. I have discussed in the class 7 already, and I can remind you this. There are the 3 types of rock. First one is known as the igneous rocks, then metamorphic rocks, then the third one is the sedimentary rocks. So depend on the parent rock. This parent rock may be the igneous, metamorphic or the sedimentary rocks. Due to pressure, increasing the pressure or decreasing the pressure or the temperature due to the climatic condition, the parent rock erodes, and the second here then rule of the third layer comes up. Weather rock material, this is the third layer, then the second layer, this one is the first, then second, the third, and the fourth. Fourth one is the where the roots of the any plant is found, then third one here the sand or silt clay found. Fourth one is the rock material, weather rocks, and here is the parent rocks. Okay, in the different if we are moving from the different regions, different area to the different area, the color of the soil will be change also due to the parent rocks. Due to the parent, like if in India you will move to the southern portion, in the Maharashtra the color of soil will be black. If you are moving to the Andhra Pradesh or the Tamil Nadu region, the color of soil will be red color. So this depend on the from which rocks they have been formed. So and what are the factors for the formations of the digit soil? And you know, the different types of the soil have the different types of fertility, and they are suitable for the different types of to growing the different types of crop. Like the in the mountain soils we can grow the coffee, tea. In the alluvial soil we can grow paddy, wheat, sugarcane, cotton. Black soil is the better for the cotton, etc. there's so many things. What are the factors for the soil formation? Factors for the soil formation is basically the nature. It depends on the nature of the parent rocks and the climatic factors. Climatic factors means the topography, like temperature is high or the low in that area, pressure is how much, and the role of the organic matters also. There is the role of the organic material also in the soil formation. Parent rocks is basically the main. And this is the main source which decide the color, texture, and the chemical property of the soil. and relief of the altitude slow it's also acclimate the soils. Flora and the fauna, microorganism, they determine the texture of the soils and fertility of the soil, how much fertile this soil is. It is defined by the flora, fauna, and the microorganisms. In the next slide, what is? Again, in the climate determines the temperature, rainfall. This also influences the weathering of the soil formation. Time also determines the thickness of the soil formation. It takes 100 superior to the max. The ones I have discussed this 1 centimeter soils in making it take the thousands or millions of the years. And this is only. And due to the humans, due to the humans, soil erosion takes place. Like we are making the industry, we are cutting the trees, and by cutting the trees, this basically do what? The roots of any plants bind the soils all together, and when we cut the plant, the roots also damage there, and that weak the soil textures and the binding of the soils. So basically, that's why the degradation of the soil takes place. The soil erode from one place to another place, and if raining in that area, the soil will be displaced from one place to another place. Also, if wind is coming too high with the high speeds, like in the typhoon or the thunderstorm area, you can see in the desert area. So the structure of the sand dunes, you have learned about it. Sand dunes were basically how forms the sand of one place move to another place by speed of the wind. This is the replace this displacement is known as the soil erosion. So major what are the major threats? Major threats of the soil is the basic first one is the human beings, and second one is the climatic conditions. Also, what are the causes of human beings? Humans do the deforestation, overgrazing of the any area. This is also cause the soil erosion. Then using of the chemical fertilizers. I have discussed these were the main cause for the soil land resources degradation. Also using the different types of the chemical fertilizers and pesticides. These are also cause for the soil degradations. So how can we conserve these soils? There are so many ways. We can use a method which is known as the mulching. Suppose we are planting some plants. So basically we have to do is just put straw over the root of this plant. This will retain the soil moisture. This will retain the soil moisture, and the water of the soil will not be evaporated by the sunlight. This method is known as lynching, mulching. We can use the counter barriers. Counter barriers means this is the U form, and just put some stone and other things which can protect the soil from taking means replacing one place to another place. We can use this the counter barrier. Terrace farming, this is basically done on the mountains area. Like mountains have the slopes, so they make the stairs like structure. And then if we are planting like a tea, they have growing the tea plants here. So basically what they increase the increase the slope of this area. Means from this direction there will be the slope. Means water can be stored in the roots of the plant. This will also retain the soil moisture. And again, another method is intercropping. Basically, in India, what we do two types of plant in a year. We can do what? Suppose this is the field. Today we are going paddy plant. After the 3 months, we are going the wheat plant. Again, next plants we can go the maize, then onions, and etc. etc. It means we can grow different types of different types of plant within a year. This is known as intercropping, and this will keep the moisture, the fertility of the soil too much higher. Counterplowing means again this type of farming done by the farmers in the mountains area. What they do is counterplowing means on the hill slope of a hill slope they make a natural barrier to stop the water flowing down to the slope. Means here is the plant and they just make a barrier here, so if raining if raining take place, the water will be collect on the root of this plant. We can make the shelter bed means here is our farm. We can plant all four sides of the field. We can plant here trees. This tree will have to reduce the speed of air, which can harm the soil from flying one place to another place. So we can make the shelter base. We can do the mixed farming, means crop rotation, and doing the crop rotation plus animal husbandry together is known as a mixed farming. Then we can utilize the fertilizers. We can replace the chemical fertilizers by the organic fertilizers. This is also another method. And we can use the high yield variety crop seeds. Basically means the seed which have the capacity to grow higher amount of any seed, have the capacity to grow basically higher amount of the any crop is known as the higher yield crop variety. We can also use this. So here is the end of video. Thank you.